ACR Bulletin Podcast, the show where we examine the latest trends affecting radiology. I'm your host, Chris Hobson, and today I'm joined by Cody Quirk, MD. Dr. Quirk is assistant professor in the Department of Radiology and Radiological Science at the Medical University of South Carolina. In addition to his medical duties, Dr. Quirk hosts the Hounsfield Unit Podcast, a podcast that focuses on what matters most to young and early career professionals, along with residents and fellows. Dr. Quirk, it's a pleasure to speak with you today.
Thanks for having me on, Chris.
Today, I'd like to shine a spotlight on your podcast, the Hounsfield Unit Podcast, that you actually host. But first, please tell us a little bit about your medical background.
Yeah, I grew up in Texas, and so I did most of my medical training there. I did Texas A&M for undergrad in medical school, and then did my residency in Dallas at Baylor University Medical Center. After that, I did a musculoskeletal radiology fellowship at Oregon Health and Science University in Portland, which was a great year. And then spent a little bit of time as faculty member at the University of Virginia. And now I'm at the Medical University of South Carolina.
Excellent. So you've kind of been all over the country.
Yeah.
That's good.
Good experiences.
It's good for a podcast host. Yeah. Well, speaking of podcasts, what led you to choose podcasting as a channel for conversation?
You know, I've always enjoyed listening to podcasts myself about, and not necessarily about medicine, but about all kinds of topics. I feel like it's a great way to spend your commute, whether it's 20 minutes or an hour. And, you know, you can learn about some topics maybe you hadn't thought of before, or just, you know, fill out some interests that you may have. So I originally started listening to them a lot when I was a resident when we were commute to some of our moonlighting. I was living in Dallas, so it would take 30, 45 minutes to get to some of these places. So I actually started off with listening to Star Talk, the one that Neil deGrasse Tyson hosts, and then went on from there. So I listened to a wide variety of stuff. Most of it's scientific these days, and listened to some radiology podcasts as well to try and make sure that I stay up to date. And I just think it's a great way to keep up with what's going on in your field. And if you can have someone who can bring these topics to you rather than having to go out and search for all the information yourself, then you're probably going to be better informed.
Yeah, and also do it as a conversation. That's always a little disarming and I think an easier entree into some subjects.
Absolutely.
Might be a little more prickly, which you actually don't shy away from on your podcast, which we'll come back to in a few minutes. So I had to look, but first I had to really look it up. I have to admit, I didn't know what a Hounsfield unit was. So for anyone out there who is like me and doesn't know what that is, can you please explain just, you know, briefly what it is and maybe why you incorporated it into your podcast title?
Yeah, so the original name was the Radio Pake Podcast, and then I found that someone had already started using that name for a different podcast. So we were searching for new names, and actually Mike Hanley, who's the vice chair of education at the University of Virginia, I have to give him credit because he recommended some of these names, and this one came up. And so a Hounsfield unit is a measurement of density on CT. So basically, it was just the perfect name for a radiology-centered podcast.
Got you. Well, it certainly got my attention. I calling it Hounsfield for the longest time, but now you've educated me on a new subject there. In your view, what are the topic? Because the way you frame the podcast is that it really does tackle the top issues affecting YPS and RFS folks out there. What, in your view, are the top issues, and how would those issues differ from someone, say, in the middle or near the end of their career?
You know, I think that there's a lot of talk about what's going on in radiology right now, and we need to kind of focus on it from our perspective. You know, a lot of it is pretty present-centered, and we have to think about these. You know, a lot of us have careers that are going to span another 20, 30 years, maybe even more. So we have to look at these different topics and see where we want to take it, because we're the ones who are going to be dealing with the fallout of whatever decisions are made right now, and whether they're good or bad. And so I think that as YPS and RFS members of the ACR, we should be educated on it. So I think that this is just the way we want to do it. And we're going to have, both sides of the story, so that people can make their own decision. And some of them are going to be a little bit eye-opening. And I have to thank my guests who've been on so far for making it as truthful as possible and trying to to get their side of things out. And whether these are easy issues or difficult issues, the private equity podcast that we did was a little bit of a hot button issue. And that one was, it was really long, but I felt like it needed to be that way just to, so people could hear everything from both sides.
And remarkably civil too, I have to say. It was a really a thought-provoking episode there. So everyone definitely check it out. You do, and this is, just as you said, you do a good job of staying balanced on your episodes, allowing guests kind of multiple sides, whether it be, we're talking private equity or, some sort of piece of legislation. Why do you think it's important to convey the balanced view and not come down with any sort of editorial standpoint?
Well, I mean, as a, I'm an academic radiologist, so I don't have the most nuanced and most up-to-date views on all of these topics. I try to stay on top of it myself, but the people I try to have on are the experts on these things, people who are experiencing it every day, or people who've written articles about these topics. So they should be the ones who tell you what's going on with it, and then you can make your decisions based off of that. So, we had the core and maintenance of certification podcast too, that it's a little bit more of an informative podcast there, kind of where the ABR is heading, and hopefully that kind of enlightened some people as to their side of things and how they're thinking about it. Obviously there's still plenty of things that we can be better on, but I think it's important to tell. I think Med Twitter has kind of taken off and people are using social media more. And there it can become kind of an echo chamber where you only hear the, certain side that you want to hear. And so by doing this, maybe we get people to open up their minds a little bit more and say, well, I didn't really think of it that way before. So hopefully that can make our specialty a little bit better.
Yeah, the longer form does seem to be coming back, making a comeback. But maybe I'm just biased as a, I guess from a journalistic standpoint, but I do think, the fact that they've expanded the word count on Twitter helps, but this longer form really, like you said, helps get the nuance in there. So
yeah, exactly. We are kind of missing that. I mean, I think Twitter, I'm on Twitter. I love it. I'm very active on it, but we can't just stay in that one space. We have to take on the longer form and get more information out of it.
Absolutely. Well, now I'm interested in how you choose your topics, because you do seem to hit a lot of the hot buttons. Do you cover kind of what's interesting to you personally, or are you more interested? Do you kind of want to try to have more of a finger on the pulse of what kind of the group as a whole is caring about?
It's a combo. Certainly, I think I try to reach out to some of the other ACR YPS members, especially Amy Patel, who's the president of our group. See what they're thinking about, reading recent JACR articles, and say, hey, that's kind of a cool thing that this person's doing. Let's learn more about it. We're going to do one coming up here about climate change and radiology. And if we can do anything to help out with that, which is a personal one that I wanted to do. I helped write a recent JACR opinion piece on that. So I think, it's a combo, and hopefully people, even if they haven't thought about these specific issues, maybe it'll kind of spark a little fire there.
Interesting. Very interesting. So can we expect a radiology and climate change podcast episode in the future?
Yeah, next month, probably. Okay. That's my next episode I'm going to start working on.
Okay. And if you're watching this in the future, go back and listen to that podcast episode. So in the 2 years since you have started your podcast, which stories stand out the most to you?
I think the private equity one was obviously one that really stood out, hearing Dr. Hawk's take on, working inside of RAD Partners and what she sees from day to day, and then getting the counterpoint from Dr. Ortiz, who's, a pretty outspoken critic of these sorts of groups. Each one made some very good points. Then I think also the ABR one, and learning a little bit more from Brent about where they want to take maintenance of certification, what the plan is for the core, especially since COVID forced them to go virtual and their long-term plans there. So it's been as much of a learning experience for me as hopefully all the listeners, and just learning how they make these decisions and kind of getting a better feel for how things work on the inside.
That's great. And if I can plug an episode of ours, we talked recently to Dr. Lincoln Berland about MOC and the ABR and all the changes you just alluded to. So go back and listen to that too, if you're interested. To our audience and to you, actually. I noticed it's kind of a fun musical sensibility you have kind of across all your podcast episodes. Does that come straight out of your musical sensibility, or is that, you know, and how does that play into the branding of the podcast? For people who haven't heard your podcast, it's kind of a hip hop flavor to it, kind of a almost like a lo-fi ambient kind of cool quality. I just wondered how you, is that all you, or is that, how does that
work? That's all me. That's what we listen to in the reading room when I'm working a good bit. We vary it up a good bit, but I think that's just a good music to have playing in the background. And, it kind of gets you into a flow, so to speak. I'm a big fan of that.
Yeah. Remind me of like a Radio Lab or something from NPR where there's little interludes, you know, and, so you had some verisimilitude there. We'll feel like we're actually in the reading room with Dr. Quirk while he's talking. This is great. Just
the exact same.
No difference. Yeah. I just wonder, you know, you already kind of at the top of the episode, you were talking about some podcasts you listened to, in addition to those scientific ones like Neil deGrasse Tyson and some of those other ones, what do you think there are some podcasts out there that our audience should know about, whether it be radiology related or not?
Yeah, on the radiology perspective, I started listening to yours here recently and joining that and all the topics that you guys cover. Another one I've been listening to is Radiographics, since they kind of rebooted it with Wendy Gibbs. She does a nice summary of the articles that they're covering that month. We spoke a little bit before we started recording about the Radiology Leadership Institute one, and kind of hearing the stories of some of these amazing radiologists, people like Dr. McGinty, Dr. Carlos, those sorts of people, and hearing their story and how they got where they are is a good one. From non-radiology, I mentioned Star Talk earlier. That's a personal favorite just because I enjoy space related stuff. I also really like, there's one it's relatively new. It's called How to Save a Planet. It's got Dr. Ayanna Elizabeth Johnson, who's a marine biologist, and it's takes a little bit different viewpoint on climate change in terms of, you know, we know this is happening, but what can we do to make it better? And they, you know, they even go down the route of what's better renewable energy. Is it solar, wind, nuclear power? Why isn't nuclear power the best, or why is it? So I think that they kind of take the same tack with climate change that I'm trying to take with my podcast in radiology, and try to kind of give you the full story on how to tackle it.
That's really interesting. Yeah, well, maybe we'll put some links to some of those podcasts in the show notes. So thanks for those recommendations. Mm-hmm. Pivoting to the future now, what are the future plans for the podcast? What directions do you see it going?
Yeah, I'm hoping to start recording even more episodes going forward. Right now, we're just shooting for once every quarter. So maybe we can try and get, you know, six a year out. More topics, things that YPS and RFS members. So if you're listening as a YPS or RFS member, please email us and let us know if there's some topics that we're not covering that you want to hear about. So just expanding it, maybe even getting some more people involved so that we can make it sound even a little bit more professional down the road. Because right now, doing it all by myself, and I'm not the most, technically abled in terms of audio editing and that sort of thing, but I'm getting there, I think. So those are my immediate goals here.
Excellent. Well, I guess, are there any YPS or RFS related activities or events or anything that we should plug here at towards the end?
We got the meeting coming up. I think they had a call for nominations for officer positions. So if you're interested in looking into that, I think that's probably the most pressing thing at this point. And then, you know, they're having the JACR tweet chats. I think there's one tomorrow night, actually, Thursday, the 26th of March, with Dr. McGinty. That should be an excellent topic. And those are the things I know off the top of my head right now, but I'm sure there's plenty more.
And the nice thing about those tweet chats is most people will probably be seeing this episode after that tweet chat, but a lot, you know, you can always go back on Twitter and usually the hashtag is, remind me again, is it just?
It's just hashtag JACR.
Hashtag JACR, okay. I think it's changed over the years.
Yeah, they also post a synopsis a lot of the times afterwards of like what everybody said. And they do want the conversation to keep going. So even if they don't hear, if you don't hear about it till after the fact and you have some thoughts, put them out there and put hashtag JACR on it.
Okay, excellent. Well, thank you so much for the conversation. If I know you said you were active on Twitter. In addition to Twitter, if anyone, or maybe that's the best place, if anyone wants to continue this conversation, where can they find you online?
Yeah, so the Hounsfield Unit has its own Twitter page, HounsfieldPod at HounsfieldPod. We have an email as well, HounsfieldPod@gmail.com. And then my personal Twitter is CQuirkMSK.
Excellent. And I'll just say that for our listeners, if you have any ideas, as with the Hounsfield Unit podcast, if you have any ideas for show topics, please let us know. You can actually let us know at the ACR Twitter handle at @RadiologyACR. I also invite everyone to check out all of our episodes at Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Podcasts, and on ACR's YouTube channel. You can always subscribe to ACR's YouTube channel to get all of our new episodes. Well, thanks again, Dr. Quirk, and thanks to our listeners. This has been the ACR Bulletin Podcast. See you next time.
Thank you, Chris.